roasting coffee, and there's some bags of coffee around the corner there if you want to see Coffeyville Coffee Company if you haven't seen the packages. What we're doing, my wife Lydia and I decided we wanted to promote Coffeyville, and this is all about coming back to Coffeyville several years ago. We wanted to help promote, inspire, create vision, bring out notable stories from the past, notable people from the past. One thing that I found is some towns, they just spring up. You know, we've been living in Texas, and north of Dallas, there'll be a cotton field, and 5 years later, it's a 30,000 person city, you know, and they don't have a history. The one thing that cities can't buy is a history. And it's, you either got it or you don't. Coffeyville has the richest history of any town I have ever seen per capita. We have found 80 stories of famous people, notable people. These are the first 25, I think, on this poster. Everybody can get one that wants one. But notable Coffeyville people. I don't know if there are any wrestling fans, but Saturday night, there was a pay-per-view wrestling match nationwide that promoted a Coffeyville native, Mildred Bliss. And so millions of people were watching this documentary on Coffeyville and Mildred Bliss's life. She grew up over here, 1507 in Maple. We know the people in the house that live there now. And she is the founder of women's wrestling. She used to wrestle men and beat them, but they wouldn't let her in the wrestling federation because she's a woman. You know, it's 1937. So she started the women's wrestling federation. She's national champion, world champion 3 times. Grew up and raised right here in Coffeyville. All these people are from Coffeyville. World heavyweight boxing champion Buster Douglas was right over here at the junior college. I used to play basketball with him. So we all know about Walter Johnson, Walter Johnson Park. We know about Phil Kennedy, Phil Kennedy High School. We know about a few other people, the Brown Mansion, the Daltons. But we kind of dug around and we got many more people, not only people, but like the world's largest hailstone. And you know, I remember that day. I was walking down the street, people's heads were bleeding from being hit by hailstones. So we took these stories and tried to create something that would inspire young people especially. So we put these posters in every elementary school classroom. We are selling coffee online, coffeeblowcoffee.com. Businesses like Terabit are selling our coffee, and each bag promotes a famous Coffeyville person. So Mildred Bliss is one. Donnie Miller, he's a Kansas Music Hall of Fame guy. A lot of people love Donnie Miller. He's got a real dark roast coffee. He said, make it as dark as you can. He wanted dark as strong as he can. So I would just, Matthew's getting separated for me here in a second. I was going to share it with you guys. But if you would like to try our coffee, let me know. If you want to order online, it's coffeefillcoffee.com. And right now we have 3 blends. One's light roast, and medium roast, and dark roast. And we're hoping to raise money to, and honestly, well, the reason we're doing the coffee is we're trying to raise money to restore properties in town. We've already restored about 10 houses around town, and some of them we've got investors to buy and to restore. Some of them we've kept. So my kids are involved. 3 of my 4 kids own properties all over Coffeyville. And one of them is actually buying a house next month over here on West 4th Street. So we're trying to renovate houses, restore houses, because housing is a big problem. We want to raise money through Coffeyville Coffee Company to restore some buildings downtown like this coffee roastery that we have apartments upstairs. We'd love to do that at other buildings downtown too, if we can make a go of it. We have other coffees, other stories coming up soon. Some of them are very, very exciting that I can't quite tell you yet. Maybe in a month I can tell you. I kind of have to have a signature on the contract, but it should be pretty exciting in the future. So these guys were supposed to bring me something when I started talking. Okay. I have these posters right here, and if you want to take a few of them, if you have a business, if you want to just hand them out to people, Zach at Chamber of Commerce, people come down here, they they want to know about Coffeyville, they know about the Dolphins, you can just let them know about the famous people in Coffeyville. What, there's one mistake in, it's Mondrell Fulcher. It's the wrong football team on his notation here, but we're going to reprint that. But everybody else is accurate, and we're going to be making copies about it. Does anybody have a question about that? Does anybody hate coffee?
Hey, Leah. How did you come across all the things? Did you do research individually, or did you go to the newspaper, library, where did you go?
Well, we started, we started, I grew up in Coffeyville, and I knew about, 12, 15 things that I figured, would be interesting. So we started just Google searching, and we actually hired a professional young lady who does branding and brand development, and she researched, and she came up with some phenomenal people that I didn't have a clue were from Coffeyville. And so I was very happy with what she came up with this for. She also designed this poster, and we're real proud of the poster because I think it's really cool. It's kind of retro, kind of like Coffeyville's great past, the retro. But it also hopefully will inspire young people. And one day I want to get to the library and look up addresses on some of these people because I would love to be able to just go to the houses and, I don't want to bug them, but just, look at the houses. Yeah. Well, let me tell you what. Matthew and Andy are busy making something, and I'm going to challenge people. Has anyone here ever had an acorn drink? What do you think?
Awesome.
Okay. They're making acorns. Does anybody really, really like coffee? Okay, candy? Candy gets one. Okay, what you got to do is you got to drink it in one go.
It's awesome.
Let's see what she does.
They're awesome.
What do you think? All right, Andy. Anybody that wants one, he's making some of these. They are very, very tasty. They are espresso shot with heavy cream and maple syrup. They're keeping the buzzing to them.
I know, it's like a little, you go through phases.
Yeah, it's hot to go home.
Yeah, that was very, very
cool. Levi, you want one?
No, thanks. You don't want to do it.
Okay.